क्लास 11th सब्जेक्ट फिजिक्स, 5th चैप्टर ग्रेविटेशन। फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर लेट अस सी द एस्केप फिलोसिटी डिनोटेड बाय फी ई, एस्केप फिलोसिटी। सो व्हेन एनी बॉडी इज थ्रोन इन द अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन फ्रॉम द अर्थ सरफेस, इट रीचेस टू ए पर्टिकुलर हाइट एंड देन इट फॉल्स डाउन ऑन द अर्थ सरफेस। Now that body is falling on the earth's surface because it is within the earth's gravitational field, and therefore due to the gravitational force it will be attracted towards the earth. But instead of that, if any body is thrown in the vertically upward direction such that it goes out of the earth's gravitational field, then the velocity possessed by that body will be nothing but the escape velocity. As that body escapes from the earth's gravitational field with that velocity, therefore that velocity will be called as escape velocity denoted by phi e. Now that escape velocity will be defined as the minimum velocity with which a body should be projected vertically upwards from the surface of the earth so that it escapes from the earth's gravitational field is called as escape velocity of that body. The minimum velocity with which a body should be thrown vertically upwards from the surface of the earth so that it escapes from the earth's gravitational field is called as escape velocity phi e of that body. That means that body must be thrown vertically upwards from the surface of the earth such that it escapes from the earth's gravitational field, that is it goes out of the earth's gravitational field with that minimum velocity which is called as escape velocity. That is, that velocity will be given from the surface of the earth only to that body. Now let us consider the kinetic energy and potential energy of any object of mass m. So here we will have to consider kinetic energy and potential energy of any object of mass m which is thrown vertically upwards with escape velocity phi e from the surface of the earth. Now when that object is on the surface of the earth, at that time when that object is on the earth's surface, when it is on the earth's surface, its kinetic energy will be equal to half m phi e square, half m phi e square, where m is the mass of that body and phi e is its escape velocity. And the potential energy of that body will be equal to gravitational potential energy, that is minus g m m upon r, where m will represent mass of the earth, small m is mass of that body, r will be the radius of the earth. And therefore when that body is on the earth's surface, its kinetic energy is half m phi e square and potential energy is minus g m m upon r. Hence the total energy of the system will be, total energy will be equal to kinetic energy plus potential energy, that is half m phi e square minus g m m upon r. Total energy will be half m phi square minus g m m upon r as equation number 1. So this will give us the total energy of that body when it is directed in the upward direction with some velocity phi e, that is escape velocity. Now the kinetic energy of the object goes on decreasing with time as it is pulled back by the earth's gravitational field. So we know that When that body is thrown in the upward direction, it will be possessing kinetic energy. But as it goes up, as time passes, its kinetic energy will go on decreasing because of the gravitational pull exerted by the earth in the downward direction. That means initially that body will be having maximum kinetic energy. As it goes up, its kinetic energy will go on decreasing, but at the same time its potential energy will go on increasing. That means here the kinetic energy will appear in the form of potential energy, and then kinetic energy will become zero when it reaches to infinity. When that object reaches at infinity height, at that time its kinetic energy will become equal to zero, and hence at infinite distance from the earth's surface, at infinite distance from the earth's surface, we can write, at infinite distance from the earth's surface, we have kinetic energy will be equal to zero because its velocity becomes equal to zero. Therefore, kinetic energy is equal to zero. And the potential energy will be again minus gmm upon infinity. This r will become infinity. And if gmm upon infinity, it will be again equal to zero. And hence, total energy for the system will be equal to, the total energy will be equal to kinetic energy plus potential energy, but both energies are zero, and therefore total energy will be equal to zero. That is equation number 2. Now, in this case, we can say that the energy is conserved, as energy is conserved. So according to law of conservation of energy, we know that energy in the universe always remains constant, and therefore only one form of energy will get converted into another form. And therefore, as energy is conserved, we can write half m phi square minus g m m upon r must be equal to zero. That is, in this case, kinetic energy will get converted into potential energy, and as energy is conserved, we can write half m phi square minus g m m upon r must be equal to zero. That is, here total is equal to zero, and therefore half m v square minus g m m upon r must be equal to zero. This energy, the sum of the kinetic energy and potential energy, this must be equal to zero by the law of conservation of energy. And therefore, we can write from this relation, half m v square, half m v square must be equal to g m m upon r. Half m phi square must be equal to g m m upon r. From this relation, the terms are separated. Therefore, m will get cancelled on both sides, small m. Then half phi square equal to g m upon r. And therefore, we can write phi square equal to 2 g m upon r. Phi square equal to 2 g m upon r, or phi will be equal to square root of 2 g m upon r, equation number 3. So here phi is equal to square root of 2 g m upon r. This is the equation for the escape velocity. From this relation, it is clear that the escape velocity will be constant since it is dependent on gravitational constant, mass of the earth and radius of the earth. And this escape velocity is independent of mass of that body. That means whatever may be the mass of any body, the escape velocity possessed by it will be the same. Now, if you put the values of g, m and r in this relation, and if we find out the value of escape velocity phi, it comes out to be 11.2 kilometer per second. 11.2 kilometer per second. That means escape velocity possessed by the body will be constant. that is square root of 2gm upon r, and it will be same for all the bodies on the earth's surface. So this will be regarding the escape velocity. Now let us see the next point, that will be earth satellites. From this, the communication satellite and the polar satellites, that we will have to study. Then let us see first the satellites. So the objects which revolve around the earth, are called as earth satellites. Moon is only the natural satellite of the earth. Some of the artificial satellites also revolve around the earth. So other artificial satellites also revolve around the earth. And now let us see what is that communication satellite. What is this communication satellite? And then we will discuss polar satellites. So what is that communication satellite? The satellites revolving around the earth in an equatorial plane with same sense of revolution as that of rotation of the earth, and with same period of revolution as the period of rotation of the earth, that is 24 hours or one day, are called as the communication satellites. The satellites revolving around the earth in an equatorial plane with same sense of revolution as that of the rotation of the earth, and with the same period of revolution as the period of rotation of the earth, that is one day or 24 hours, are called as communication satellites. That is, communication satellites revolve around the earth in equatorial plane, and the sense of revolution of that planet is same as that of sense of rotation of the earth, that is from west to east, as well as the period of revolution of that satellite is same as the period of rotation of the earth, that is one day or 24 hours. So such type of satellites are called as the communication satellites. Now, as the sense of rotation of the earth and satellite, as well as period of revolution of that satellite, is same as that of period of rotation of the earth, due to this, these satellites appear to be stationary when it is observed from the earth's surface. These satellites will be observed to be stationary or at rest when they are observed from the earth's surface, and hence they are called as geostationary or geosynchronous satellites. These satellites are used for communication, television transmission, telephones, and radio wave signal transmission. For example, INSAT group of satellites are launched by India. INSAT groups of satellites are launched by India, and these are the communication satellites. Now let us see the next one, that is polar satellites. What are these polar satellites? So as its name suggests, these satellites will be going around the poles, and therefore the satellites going around, that is revolving around the poles of the earth in north-south direction, in north-south direction and having period of revolution nearly 85 minutes are called as polar satellites. The satellites going around the poles of the Earth in the north-south direction and having period of revolution nearly 85 minutes are called as polar satellites. Now, these satellites are used for weather forecasting and meteorological purposes. They are also used for astronomical observations and the study of solar radiations. So these are the two satellites, that is communication satellite and polar satellites. And now let us see the next point, that is projection of a satellite. Now how satellite is projected in the space, that we will have to study. So for the projection of the satellite, generally rockets are used. Then for the propagation of satellite, it must be having a particular velocity. With a particular velocity, that satellite must be launched, and it must be projected with minimum two-stage rocket. So there are rockets having various stages, like single stage rocket, two stage rocket, or multi stage rockets. Like these different types of rockets are available. Now out of this, minimum two stage rocket is needed for the projection of this satellite. So when the satellite is projected with single stage rocket, if that satellite is projected with the help of single stage rocket, then it will be raised vertically up to a particular height. Then its vertical velocity of projection is less than escape velocity. If the vertical velocity of projection of that satellite is less than escape velocity, the satellite will return to the Earth's surface. So satellite will return to the Earth's surface if the horizontal velocity of projection or the vertical velocity of projection of that satellite is less than the escape velocity. Then the satellite will return to the Earth's surface. On the other hand, if vertical velocity is greater than escape velocity, if the vertical velocity is greater than the escape velocity, then that satellite will escape from the Earth's gravitational field, so that it will not be used for the communication purpose. That means when any satellite is projected with a velocity which is less than escape velocity, then that satellite will move to a particular height and then it will fall down on the Earth's surface. Instead of that, if that satellite is projected with a velocity greater than escape velocity, then it will escape into the free space. And therefore, in both these cases, we can say that these satellites cannot be used for the communication purposes. And hence, for the projection of the satellite, instead of a single stage rocket, minimum two stage rocket is used. With the help of first stage of the rocket, the satellite is taken to a desired height. So how working of this two stage rocket takes place? Let us see. With the help of first stage of rocket, the satellite will be taken to the desired height above the Earth's surface. Then that launcher is rotated, that means that rocket will be rotated in horizontal direction, that is through 90 degree with the help of remote control, and the first stage of the rocket will be again detached. So first of all, first fuel in the first stage will be ignited, so that rocket along with that satellite will reach to a particular height. Then when it reaches to a desired height, at that time with the help of remote control, the total system will be rotated in the horizontal direction, so that satellite will point in the horizontal direction, and then the first stage of the rocket, that is the empty stage, will be detached. It will be removed with the help of remote control. Then with the help of the second stage of that rocket, with the help of this second stage, that is fuel in the second stage of that rocket will be now ignited. Then it will be taken to a specific horizontal velocity. Now when it is rotated through 90 degree, at that time a specific horizontal velocity, VH, is given to that satellite, so that it can revolve around the Earth in circular orbit or in different orbits. So after rotating that system, that launcher, then their particular or specific horizontal velocity will be given to that satellite, so that it can revolve around the Earth. And now let us see the different paths followed, the paths followed by the satellite. So depending upon the horizontal velocity imparted to that satellite, it will revolve along different paths around the Earth. So here in this diagram, the different paths are shown. So in this case, here there will be Earth. This is the Earth. Around the Earth in elliptical orbit, first one, that is elliptical orbit, this satellite will be revolving, which is present at the point P. Then second path trace is circular orbit. It will be circular orbit. Again, third one is elliptical path again. There is elliptical path. Third path is elliptical path. Fourth path will be here, that is parabolic path. This will be the parabolic path. And then fifth path will be nearly straight line, that is nearly parallel to this horizontal velocity. So like this, different paths will be traced by that satellite when it is projected. Now this will depend upon the horizontal velocity of projection. That means one by one these cases will be discussed. First one is, if horizontal velocity of projection is less than critical velocity. So critical velocity is nothing but it is a particular velocity. Further we will discuss it. So if horizontal velocity is less than critical velocity, then that satellite will move along the elliptical path around the Earth. So when, in this case, when this horizontal velocity is less than critical velocity, then that satellite will move along the elliptical path with the point of projection far away from the Earth. For this elliptical path, the point of projection will be far away from the Earth. And therefore we can say that if horizontal velocity is less than critical velocity, that satellite will move along an elliptical path around the Earth with point of projection far away from the Earth. Then second case, if horizontal velocity is equal to critical velocity, then the satellite will move along a circular path. So if VH is equal to VC, circle will be traced by the satellite. And therefore, in this case, we can say that if VH is equal to VC, then the circular path will be traced by that satellite around the Earth. And therefore, we can say that if the horizontal velocity is equal to critical velocity, the satellite moves in a stable circular orbit around the Earth. Then we'll go for third one. इफ हॉरिजॉन्टल वेलोसिटी इज ग्रेटर देन क्रिटिकल वेलोसिटी बट लेस देन एस्केप वेलोसिटी, इफ हॉरिजॉन्टल वेलोसिटी इज ग्रेटर देन क्रिटिकल वेलोसिटी बट लेस देन एस्केप वेलोसिटी देन अगेन दैट सैटेलाइट विल मूव अलोंग द इलिप्टिकल पाथ बट हियर द पॉइंट ऑफ प्रोजेक्शन विल बी क्लोज टू द अर्थ सर्फेस. सो अलोंग दिस पाथ that is elliptical path that satellite will now move, but in this case the point of projection will be close to the earth, and therefore we can say that if horizontal velocity is greater than critical velocity and less than escape velocity, then the satellite moves in elliptical path with the point of projection close to the earth. Then let us go for fourth case, that is if horizontal velocity is equal to escape velocity, if horizontal velocity is equal to escape velocity, then that satellite follows a parabolic path. The satellite follows the parabolic path. So when in this case, here it is written parabolic path, VH is equal to VE. So when VH is equal to VE, the satellite will move along a parabolic path, and therefore we can say that if horizontal velocity is equal to escape velocity, the satellite moves along a parabolic path and it never returns to the point of projection. And then let us consider the fifth one condition. If horizontal velocity is greater than escape velocity, if horizontal velocity is greater than escape velocity, that satellite will escape from the Earth's gravitational field. That means it will enter into the free space. So in this case, this fifth path will be followed by it, for which this VH is greater than VE. And therefore, in this case, we can say that if horizontal velocity is greater than the escape velocity, the satellite will escape from the Earth's gravitational influence. If the horizontal velocity is greater than the escape velocity, then the satellite will escape from the Earth's gravitational influence. So this will be all about the projection of satellite. So in this way, the projection of the satellite will take place.